Hello everyone and welcome back to another video. I finally got myself that headset I wanted, so yeah, this is actually my very first review, and we're currently in American Truck Simulator, and I'm gonna make a review of this. So this is the Freightliner FLB. Right now we're currently in middle of Fresno and Bakersfield. So what we're gonna do with this is that we're gonna take this here. The test drive comes before upgrades, but well, that's okay, I can live with that. So let's fire this baby up. And I mean, listen to this. That's awesome. I love it. So, yeah. And, beautiful. I love it. I can't believe it. I can't believe it. Thank you. get in here. And we go to that. So, you can only have one cab, but you can have 6x4 and 4.2 chassis. But, I mean, this doesn't look good, to be honest. I don't like it, so I go with that. You can have both Caterpillar and ISX15 engines. And, well, I like them both, but, I mean, Caterpillar is one of my favorite brands, so, yeah, I go with Caterpillar. Now we come to the issues. You can have 18 gear, RTLO 2291-8B AS 18 speed with retarder. The problem I have with this is that the gears won't hop into place, so to speak. Well, I can just show you. So we do this because, yeah, I can. I can show you what I mean. Now I think this goes as I want it to go. I haven't even tried the others yet, but if you want to do that, you can do that. But 13 for me is minimum. So, now we come to the interior, and here we got that one, and of course, standard. So, I like the old buddy, but for some reason, I like that steering wheel, but it's not really my style in American trucks, so I like that better. Now we come to the skins. So you have Freightliner FLB USF, and it's really good. I like it when it looks like a well-used truck. So you I've used it a lot, and it's dirty, yeah. It just looks like it's gonna fall apart soon. Same with that one. I think it would look very, very cool when it's clean and not all the rust and all that. But actually, I think it's kind of charming when it's like that. Then we have that one, and I think that looks good when it's clean too, but I like when, I find that one more realistic, actually, to be honest. I'm just honest with you. So that's my personal favorite, and I like that too, actually, but I don't think that it looks good with this truck. I don't know. You can tell me your opinions if you want to. I don't mind at all. So you have single colors as well. Then you have that one. And yeah, this looks good. And it's, well, I guess it's the cleanest one of them. And it even have a truck number here for the company. So it's Sherman Broad's Heavy Trucking. So yeah, and you can see the details in the trucks very good with this too. So yeah, I like that. I like that. It looks good with these tanks and all that. Here we only have single colors, even metallic. So yeah, you can have, so you can change the color as you want. We do that. Here you have all the details, screws and everything. And if you ask me, this is an amazing, well modeled truck. So everything looks great. So yeah, and now I'm gonna take my skin back. There we go. Ah, it's beautiful. I love it. Now we come to accessories, and here we got pipes. So you can have almost everything, actually. Maybe I should go with that. I don't know. Well, yeah, you can have only one pipe, and it looks good. It looks, well, I don't know. Let's see. Yeah, I'm just gonna answer the person who called me. I'm gonna answer with a text. Let's see. There we go. There we go. Now I'm done. And you also have a short version of that. So you have a long and short version of every pipe. That's the one I'm using because I think it looks awesome with the skin, with the tank, everything. So yeah, now when I showed you that, we have this. Some of you know what that is. You can have that. And for some reason, I don't like it. That, as I use, and you can also have that. So here you see a big logo here, and I don't know, I don't want that. I think it looks kind of silly, actually. So I use that because if you ask me, the truck looks a little bit tougher. Interior light. Do you want interior light? No, I don't want any interior lights. So here we got that. And if you press that button, the horns don't come automatically. So you have to put them in afterwards. Like that. That was just for showing you. So, you can even have horns here if you want to. And then it looks like that. So I don't think it looks that good, actually. You can put them in any spot you want. You can even, well, now we come to visor. So you can have chrome and paint, and well, I don't think the chrome visor looks so good, actually. It looks kind of like metallic painting. So no, I don't want that. I want it to be a little bit lighter. So I go with a paint visor, and it also have the company's logo here. So yeah, that's cool, I guess. Okay, we come to that later. Now we come to the front. What can I do with the front? Well, we have add-ons. And you can, in anywhere here, put lights. So we have a few lights we can put there if we want to. And this one is actually a flashing beacon. So I'm gonna do this, and we put one there, and look now. So yeah, that's kind of cool if you're driving heavy loads, like heavy machines or anything like that. I don't do that, so I see it kind of pointless having them for me. So no, I'm not gonna use that, but you can if you want to. I don't want to pay for the opportunity, so I remove that. You can even change the bumper. Surprise, surprise, you can do that almost everywhere, and you can do a whole lot with it, actually. But I can't have any mud flaps, so no, I'm not gonna. But in any of these slots, you can have these if you want to. And even here, you can put lights down here if you want to. I haven't done that because I like this better for some reason, for just this truck. You got little old plastic chrome. And actually, I think it looks kind of good, but the chrome melts in too good with the plastic, actually, so I don't think it looks that realistic. I mean, chrome, I would prefer that kind of style on it. So, no, that's why I don't use chrome. And you can even have old plastic. And you see the difference, it just looks a little cleaner here. So, no, I don't like it for that reason. So I go with this, because I think it looks too damn good. Let's see if I can find... Yeah, here we got the mirrors. You can't do anything about it. They say it's chrome, and it's shiny as I don't know what. But I would say more metallic black, actually. I don't know, but no, I don't like that. It's the chrome in this game is way too dark, so yeah. Tires. You have standards, or and if you have mods, and here, there I want to use chrome. But something that disturbed me a little bit. I'm gonna see if I can change that. Premium. There we go. Yeah, I hope it stays this way now, actually. But yeah, tires is kind of standard. You can change mud flaps, but you can change fenders. So use fenders, plastic, aluminum, and chrome. I'm gonna go with the chrome, actually. I think it looks good. Even though it's too dark. I mean, come on. The chrome is way too dark. But no one says anything because they like it. But I don't. I want an opportunity for it to be realistic. OBC, you can remove that and you can put that back in. And you can have signs, only the standard one. GPS comes automatically, of course. You can even have a dash cam if you want to. Here you change visor. You can have the radio, so you can remove that and you can put that back in. It doesn't come with a truck, so you have to customize that in. You can also have a mirror if you want to. I don't want that because I don't think it looks good. You can also have a mirror here, and I never used that mirror in any truck that I use. For some reason that was those mirrors, I don't know. And this you can remove, and it looks like that. And you can put that back in. So, yeah, I think that was almost it. You can't change the steering wheel here, fortunately. The only way you're doing that is with this. So let's take it for a drive. Again, just because we love it and we do this. Ah, come on, that's a long way to go, that one. Should I take that? Yes, I will take that. So, now we have our little baby here customized and done. I have one more thing to put out. When you're coming to this page, the only... You can't... change the steering wheel. As you can see, it doesn't move the slightest bit in any way. But you can change this if you want to. So, that's about it. And you can also change this. So, yeah, what you can do is, of course, this, but I don't want that either. I take it there, I think. Yeah, and one up, and down with the head. There we go. Okay, now, I'm too high instead. Crap. There we go. So let's fire this thing up and change the computer so I can see my speed there. Now we back this baby. truck maneuvers so good. I'm gonna see what I have here. That was a shorty drive. Well, actually, I think I'm gonna go with this job. Thank you. as we go today is around here. So I'm gonna take you along on this road, and then I'm gonna stop the video when I come up here. So
thank you.
to take a look at the planes. I love airplanes, okay? Let's see if I can... Okay, that's cool. That's cool. Let's see. Oh my god. All American Airlines. Okay. Sure. Crown Lines. Let's see how good details these planes have. Oh my god, they even have flaps. Cool. Flaps, rudder. Nice. Nice. See if I can see, think that actually might be a beacon. Oh, this one does have their flaps down. That's cool. I don't know if I can see a taxi light there, to be honest. Cool. And I can't see landing lights though whatsoever. No beacon. So this plane actually missing a lot of lights. That's a little bit of a shame. But yeah. And well, I hear from you later. Thank you very much, and bye bye.